Hi, I'm John Coase. In this video, we're going to answer the question, how is economics related to the practice of law? Today, we look at the connection between law and economics. We will consider what a couple of eminent jurors have said. Then we'll discuss the work of notable economists who pioneered the application of economics to law. Finally, we'll review the many ways that economics is used in court. In The Path of Law, Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes, Jr. commented, "For the rational study of the law, the man of the future is the man of statistics and the master of economics." In his essay, In Law and Economics, Justice Richard Posner explained, "The legal system contains many parallels to and overlaps with the systems that economists have studied successfully." Many economists devote their time and energy applying economic analysis to legal issues. One of the pioneers is Dr. Ronald Coase, who defined the nature of a business firm in terms of transaction cost. He explained that the more transactions that can be handled cost effectively within a business, the larger that firm will be. Nobel Prize recipient Gary Becker modeled human behavior as investments in human capital, distribution of work and leisure time in the family, rational behavior in crime and punishment, and discrimination in markets for labor and goods. Today, economic analysis is applied to many areas of law, including antitrust issues, industrial regulation, taxation policy, and financial loss damage determination. Furthermore, the application of economics is extended to other areas of legal practice, including property law, contracts, torts, criminal law, civil procedure, and constitutional law. In the economy of the United States, the two major applications of economic theory and analysis are in the intellectual foundation of deregulation and as the force behind antitrust law in respect to corporations. To sum up, we have seen that jurists and economists have understood the connection between law and economics for a long time, and that economic analysis has become inseparable from the passage and enforcement of our national laws. We hope that you have enjoyed today's presentation. Want more law and econ? Then click on the icon and I'll see you on the next page.